Tuesday, June 12th, 2012. Rain last night, so this rug is saturated. This rug's gotta come out. It's just ridiculous. It's been doing this for like over a year. So I'm gonna work on moving this desk. I got it covered with stuff now. And I've already pulled out the computer system, and I'll bring this whole thing over there and get it off the rug. I gotta get this rug up to the point where I can roll it up and take it out, regardless of what George says, because this is just not healthy. It's gotta come out. Anyway, there's no gas in the truck, so I'm going to take a bus up to the library. Hopefully it won't be raining that much. I don't know what else I'm going to be doing. There's still no electric. This is day 14. No electric. This is 2 weeks. So, on we go. I took the bus for a bit. Then I got off because I'm bored already. I'm going to just walk to the library from this point. Get a little bit of a walk since it's not raining. Yeah, starting a long walk home from the library. Just able to upload the video and catch up. I made a list of using my camera as a flash card of my banks. I gotta try to find a way to get this all back where I can do it on my cell phone. I'm working on the caffeine situation. Alright, I'm gonna start on this rug moving project and the desk moving project. So I can't vacuum because there's no electric. I'll have to just sweep the rug. It's not really gonna be my problem. I'm just gonna clean it the best I can. That'll be that. I'm going to pull this sucker out of there. Yeah, it is harder finding space to move anything to. I got it half clear here to start the roll. Start rolling this damn carpet up. They all moldy. Yeah, I figured I'd roll it diagonally just to get a spot to put all this crap and mop this area. Then I'll straighten it out and roll it laterally. And I guess I'll fill the tub up with water and let it warm up a bit, because it's nice and hot up here. Well, not nice and hot, but it's hot up here in the apartment. So maybe I can get that water down from sub-freezing to a normal level to wash stuff with. I'll start with the dishes. And then I'll drain it and clean the tub again, and then I'll take a bath tomorrow morning. Actually, I'm going to do it this way. The first batch I'm going to clean the tub with. Second batch I think I'm going to do some laundry with. I'll have to get some ropes to hang it up or something to dry. The third batch, well, after I'm doing some laundry, I'll wash some dishes that way and take a bath. I gotta figure out a way to get some kind of a platter that doesn't burn all day long. I lose about a quarter of a day charging batteries as it is. Yeah, the rug dampness has actually caused this desk to start flaking off at the bottom. I'm not really going to plan to salvage this. This is a thrift shop desk for maybe $20 or $25 or something. You can keep this. The front piece of the desk just fell off. can see the black mold from the carpet. I'm gonna have to sand that off. Glue this back on. And that's where the desk was sitting. No black mold underneath. This carpet's crap, but I know he's gonna wanna keep it or sell it or something stupid. Well, that's a start. I'm gonna actually move it a little to the right and put this computer. It's actually an entertainment center thing that I'm using as a for my router and crap. My printer, holding my printer on it. I'll put that over there on the left. I have another printer. I want to set up my laser printer. I may pull this one completely out. I don't even use it because I can't afford the ink. I'll put this in storage and just put my laser printer on it. And down in some austerity. Well, the tub's finally filled up. This thing's humongous, so it takes a long time. I'm going to use this water to clean it. And move on from there. That's about as clean as I can get this thing without using kind of cleanser or something. If after washing clothes in here with the tide and everything, if it's still going to be problems with this towel, it'll get some Ajax. The kind of clothes are really go to town on this thing. Okay, I guess I'll test it on my yellows. This scenario. I normally wash with hot water. I had to rinse it out. I spilled some sediment or something kept coming out of there. So I'll just let this still for a while. So the whole tub, I should be able to rinse out the soap and stuff. I'm really allergic to the soap, so I've been like washing them twice. Doing this tub's gonna take a heck of a lot more water, but like 8 times the water. But I should be able to get them clean, even with the cold water. I'll have to put them in a soak mode for a little bit, I guess. Yeah, it's a start. I got the rug started rolling up. It's a little jammed up there, but I can straighten that out once I move all that crap. So, phase 2 about to begin since I mop the rest of the floor that just so is borrowed George's broom and dustpan. That'll help a little bit. These nuts. Okay, see all this dust? That's because George, years ago, went in the attic after he did a sheetrock job, took all the plaster, thinking it would insulate the wall, poured plaster into the wall. So the plaster is actually about 6 feet high up in the wall here. So what happens, and it goes all the way to the downstairs. So what happens is the house fills with plaster dust all the time because it's all in the walls. Because he didn't want to go to the dump. That's the real reason was. Another thing I'm going to do as part of my shutting down to leave here, since we aren't setting up computer center up here, we had started with this. That's actually where the wall is supposed to go. That's why it's recessed like that. And I put a little plate in there, and we were going to take all this old thick plaster out and put and redo the insides, because get all that plaster out that he poured down the wall, and repair the framework, whatever needed to be done, repair the electrical work, and have 2 outlets here for computers. One would have been a Cat5 and a video feed. The other one would have been electric. But George sent that project south, so I'm going to just fill this all in with spackle. I'm going to get a bunch of lath and spackle and just fill the whole damn thing in. So all these holes I'll fill in. I'm going to paint this room white one last time. Or whatever color he's got laying around, since he's not going to buy any paint, and I'm sure not buying it. That's not my job. And I'll just fill in, I'll buy the spackle to fill in all the nail holes and crap that I put in. I'll buy a little thing of spackle, but that's about it. I almost got this swept. I just got to sweep the last little piece there. It's all wet from it raining. And then I'll mop it. Yeah, my homemade washing machine is still filling.
About halfway up.
Starting to get a grip on it now. It's all mopped out. So I'll let that dry a little bit. And I'll bring some more furniture over. And I'll start moving on to the rest of the house after I'm done that. Nothing else to do. I might as well clean everything up. Good to finally filled. Alright, this is how much I usually use in the washer. I don't know if the higher volume of water is going to make a difference. Because I'm going to wash it longer. We'll see. Alright, now for the hand agitator, actually working pretty good. It's good isometrics for your arms. It's hard on the arms, but it's actually working pretty good. I'm going to do this for about 10-15 minutes. I've only been doing it for about 3 minutes. You can feel the dirt already. I'm going to do it for about 10-15 minutes. I'll drain it, then I'll fill it and rinse it. Then I'll drain it, then I'll fill it and rinse it again. And that should be good enough. Alright, now I'll let this drain for a bit and I'll start filling it up again. Now for rinse one, I didn't film it, but there was like a big line of dirt that it drained off. So this is actually really, really getting it clean this way. Tide is so good, it's making these little footprints and crap come off that have probably been on here since the 70s. Yeah, Tide is good stuff. I didn't think the cold would work, I didn't know, but it worked good. These weren't even that dirty, I can imagine what it's going to do with the whites. Those are looking pretty clean now. Wow, this room smells super musty. Now that I rolled up this rug, partially. That's sick. It's probably a health hazard. You can't have that crap all the time. This tub really takes forever to fill and cleaned all the debris, and this is ready to roll. Jeez, this thing's still filling. I wonder how many gallons this thing takes. Okay, phase two is ready to sweep and mop. I'm starting to sweep in this hallway area as well. After my bedroom project, I'm going to get into this project. You can see all the wires. It's because George had the electric off upstairs here since last year. And I was running wires from his. Now his is off too for the last couple weeks, so there's no electric in the whole house. I keep cleaning this, but you know, you kind of give up because everything keeps falling out of the ceiling here. I really need a big canister vac or something to get all this crap out of here so it stops falling down. All right, this is full. Time for the second agitation. Well, on for rinse two. It was weird that last rinse. I got a flea, a bunch of black specks, a bunch of hairs. Weird. Alright, this is all mopped and ready for phase three. Moving the next layer of furniture and crap over. I'm going to have to let it dry out a little. It's already 4:30, so I don't think I'm going to be able to finish this project. In fact, I may stop there because I don't want to go to have to sleep next to this stupid rolled up mold infested rug that smells like mildew. So I'm probably just going to I'll move the furniture over tonight, but I'm just going to wait till tomorrow to finish rolling this out. So I got to move this cabinet. Everything else. It's work. Anyway, I gotta charge up my phone battery and I gotta start charging some camera batteries or this camera's not gonna have batteries. What I'm gonna do is, right after this fill and rinse, then I'll put these out to dry and then I'll do my battery situation. You know, cook some dinner before it's dark. Too dark to cook. Yeah, I've lifted noodles tonight. I think what I'm going to do, I don't have any passwords for my banks or credit cards or anything. What I'm going to do, I don't trust hooking my USB up to the library or the college. So I'm going to risk my inverter. I'm going to calculate the electric draw on these computers. I'll try to set up the lowest draw one and risk burning out my inverter to try to print out a copy of my passwords so that I can access my stuff through my cell phone. Because otherwise I'm going to have a collapse in a couple weeks. This electric's staying off a couple weeks, and then after that, supposedly the internet's staying off, and possibly the water. So I got to dig in here somehow. I really should get a bigger inverter. I'm doing a little math, and I'm finding out that I can't even run this with a heavy-use monitor and printer like that. If I cut out the printer, all I'm going to be able to do with a 300 watt inverter is get 2.72 amps. Monitor is going to take 1.8. I may be able to run the computer and the monitor, maybe, barely, maybe. I'm not going to be able to run the printer. I wonder if I, no, I can't. I don't know, I'll have to write them down or something, and maybe I can get a cheaper power monitor somewhere. Well, whatever this is won't come out of my nice golf shirt. It looks like ink or something. Maybe get some yellow dye or something. I don't know what the heck it is. Well, I guess I'll let that air dry on my exercise machine here. This one came out pretty good. I'm pretty sure I got ring around the collar. Ugh. Can't win. I hate cleaning with cold water. Nothing gets totally clean. Anyway, I'm going to just hang this one up here. I think I got this from my brother-in-law. I don't remember. I'm going to hang that pillowcase. That's actually George and Mariana's pillowcase. That, goes with the bed. The bed's theirs too. It's not mine. I'll just let that air dry. This is such a bizarre situation. Anyway, I'm going to dry that one there. Here's my sweat hog shirt I won for selling a bunch of houses when I was a real estate agent in Jersey years ago. And last but not least, my yellow towel. Hanging that on the exercise equipment as well. This is ridiculous. I don't know how long it'll take for this stuff to dry. This is a really humid environment here. Yeah, what a mess. Anyway, rather than waste all this water, I might as well pre-soak my wipes. I gotta find more socks. A lot of my socks have been mysteriously vanishing.
some reason.
Yeah, that's all the whites I can find. What a project. Yeah, I gotta go charge my phone battery and go cook some food. I gotta charge some camera batteries tonight. Well, I'm gonna cook up some Lipton chicken noodle sides. I'm eating some Tostitos left over from the neighbor. I like these Lipton sides. They're nice and simple. Wish I had a timer. I have my phone in the car charging, so nothing to, I don't know where to watch, so I have to guess at 7 minutes. Yeah, the gas ran out. I have to restart it. Starting to look good though. We need a plan.
I got a plan. I'm taking care of all the bills I have to take care of first. They come first. Everything else is, doesn't make a difference. And that's what I'm doing. And I already mentioned that way before this too.
I think you should buy a outdoor barbecue grill.
No. Don't need one. I already got one.
No, I mean one that uses propane gas.
Oh,
it's probably cheaper. It's probably cheaper to buy the propane.
No, I don't need that. It ain't cheaper.
Than those little bottles, you know?
Nope.
Why not?
Because I don't need it. I don't do that much cooking outside anyway, so. Just do a little bit, that's all. Just to break up. There, hang on. You just, if you plan the stuff, you know, to make what you're going to make for 3 days, 4 days like that, that's easy. Then you got it, you just do it.
You need ice.
I don't need ice anymore.
You have eggs and you have mayonnaise.
I don't need ice.
What about for the eggs and mayonnaise?
I don't know. There's no eggs.
You have two eggs laying out right on the counter.
They're cooked. They ain't gonna go bad. They're all hard-boiled eggs.
Hard-boiled eggs go bad, eventually.
Yeah. The hard-boiled eggs, they're already cooked.
I was looking for you.
I'm hiding.
How much you want to get?
What gas you put? What?
Mid-grade. It's $3.29 plus whatever your discount is.
What, you got 89?
That's yeah, 89. Whoa. Octane stuff.
Put 16 in.
Hey, I'll give it. Can I give it to her?
I gotta go get. I gotta get 16.
Just tell her pump 5. Mid-grade 16.
Yeah.
Anyway, my phone was overheating, so it didn't really get charged very much. I'm just charging it in this now. Now we're getting Kroger's gas. It's got that ethanol crap in it because we can't make it to any other gas station. He all of a sudden comes up with gas money when he needs to go somewhere. Anyway. It's about 20 to 8. Well, my water leaked out. I should just have enough time to wash this batch before it, wash this batch before it gets, dark. I don't know where I'm gonna hang all this stuff though. That's the problem. I have to clean some hangers. Yeah, it's pouring out. We're getting Florida's weather now. Jeez, they come out of the blue. I got my phone out there charging. Well, you can't see in this room because it's too dark. But I bet you can hear the water hitting the floor. It used to hit the rug, now it's just going to hit the air floor. can see it puddling up over here. It's going to run more than it normally did. I could drill a small hole in the floor and let it go downstairs. I don't know, that might be tempting if it's going to be puddling up over here. We'll have to see after a few rainstorms how it runs. I don't know if you can see anything really with this lighting. Anyway, I got the rug. Oh, I showed you this before where the rug was. I'm just going to leave it here for tonight. I'll probably move my dresser to the other side of it. I'll do some work here. It's almost dark while the tub is filling. After the tub is filled, I'll wash the clothes and then start with a rinse process like it did before. By then it'll be dark and my phone will be charged. Then I can start charging these camera batteries. Weird, about 8 cars went by. Stopped and all these guys got out. I guess they're gonna... I guess this guy ran out of gas or something. I don't know, I can't leave my key sitting in here with all this crap happening out of here. Well, I can see this is turning into a candlelight deal. I'm going to have to wash them again. They're still filthy. I can't get it out. Hot water does so much better. I'm going to give it another shot at Tide and... 2 months, it's like 3 more fills, so it's going to be dark. I'll have to get candles in here. Yeah, the clothes are drying a lot faster than I thought they would. That's cool. These should be dry by tomorrow afternoon, maybe. So I'm sitting out here watching my video uploads and so making sure that everything's okay. I'm charging my phone up. Anyway, there's really nothing worth talk about anymore. I'm going to finish up with this. I don't think I'm going to charge my camera battery. I'm going to save it, and I'll work on this camera battery situation tomorrow. So y'all have a good night. I'll see you tomorrow.